Good morning viewers, you are watching Entertainment World. Today I am going to tell you about the Inception's 10 quotes that will make you think. When it was first announced that Christopher Nolan was working on an action movie about a team of specialists to enter people's dreams to steal ideas, a lot of moviegoers were skeptical. For starters, the director was mid-Batman trilogy, so moviegoers were more excited to see the Dark Knight story wrap up than some other movie. Also, it was an original story about a dream heist, so audiences were not on board initially. However, it turned out to be one of the most critically acclaimed, that highest grossing movies of the year. So here are 10 Inception quotes that will make you think. The number 10 is, dreams feel real while we are in them. It is only when we wake up that we realize something was actually strange. This might be the most thought-provoking quote in the whole movie. Cobb makes a fantastic point about the psychology of dreams. It is probably the first thing that comes up in the lecture about that part of human psychology. But to a common audience, like the people who are watching Inception as opposed to the professional consultant who informed its script, it is an innovation. Cobb says, dreams feel real when we are in them. It is only when we wake up that we realize something we actually strange. This is true, but it is not something that most people would consider without watching the movie. The number 9, come back to reality dome. Michael Caine is a Christopher Nolan's go-to guy for a wise old mentor figure who explains things to the lead, and there is a good reason for that. Caine is one of the world's finest actors, with an impressive resume that includes roles in some of the greatest movies ever made. And he gets Nolan's style, playing all the ambiguous moments like this one with a knowing smile that sells the idea that there is actually a definitive answer to everything. His character Miles too integral to Cobb's story arc at the heart of the film, and his Cobb's tie between reality and the dream world. He even tells him at the point, come back to reality dome. The number 8, that made that many dreams within dreams is too unstable. This quote from Yusuf relates to the plot, but it might as well be referring to the movie itself. As soon as we started entering dreams within dreams, the common moviegoer was lost. They still enjoyed the spectacle, like the snowbound James Bond rescue action sequence and a train flying through a city street, but their grasp of the plot was gone. This is where, if you hit the movie a certain way, it actually gets a little meta. When the team started mentioning the ideas of entering dreams once inside a dream, Yusuf said that many dreams within dreams is too unstable. Tweak the slightly and it's that many dreams within dreams is too difficult to follow, which echoes the thoughts of many audience members. The number 7, building a dream from your memory is the easiest way of losing your grasp on what's real and what is a dream. Dom Cobbs doesn't come up on a lot of lists of the greatest movies character in recent memory because of concept and plot of Inception over to the response to its characters. Still, Cobb is a complex guy who bring up a lot of important points. One of those points has to do with the creation of dreams. Never recreate places from your memories. Always imagine new places. One only use details. A street lamp or a phone booth. Never entire areas. Building a dream from your memory is the easiest way of losing your grasp on what's real and what is a dream. Number 6. I am still dreaming. Sergio says this when Cobb throws him onto the floor and starts yelling at him. Tell us what you know. Tell us what you know now. Sergio feels the carpet he's laying on, realizes that it is made of polyester and not the wool. That is, actual carpet in the apartment is made out of, which is how he figured out he is still inside his own head. The whole movie is surreal, dizzying trip, and it is all down to the little detail like this. For all we know, Cobb is still dreaming at the end of the movie. So this is the meaningful quote. The number 5. An idea is like a virus. When Christopher Nolan had the idea to make an action-heist movie set in people's dreams, he must have thought he was crazy and put off developing it for quite some time. As we know, it turned into one of the greatest movies in recent memory. But on paper, before all that, it must have sounded pretty odd. But in the film, Cobb makes an excellent point about ideas. An idea is like a virus. It is silent, highly contagious, and even the smallest seed of an idea can grow. It can grow to define or destroy you. Everything, whether it is a political movement or a war or a technological innovation or a heist movie about dreams, can be traced back to a single parasitic idea that appeared in someone's head and refused to go away. The number 4, who would wanna be stuck in a dream for 10 years? Depends on the dream. Inception is like the Matrix in a lot of ways, but its psychology of dreams is a lot more accurate than the Matrix science of cyberspace. At one point, Yusuf explains brain functions in the dream will be about 20 times normal. When you enter a dream within that dream, the effect is compounded. It's 3 dreams, then that's 10-hour dreams. When Ames is confused by this, Cobb explain it is a week, the first level down, 6 months, the second level down, and the third level. Ariadne butts in 10 years. Who would wanna be stuck in a dream for 10 years? Yusuf adds, depends on the dream. The number 3. Do you want to take a leap of faith or become an old man filled with regret, waiting to die alone? This is a line that we can all relate to. Well, we had to gender neutralize it to make it truly relate to everyone, but the sentiment can be felt by everyone, because leaps of faith can feel threatening and uncertain before the fact. It is only after we have actually taken the leap of faith that we realize whether or not it was a good thing. But Seto still makes a good point. Do you want to take a leap of faith or become an old man filled with a regret waiting to die alone? Whether or not taking that leap of faith leads to a good thing is unclear. But if you don't at least take the leap, you'll end up old and full of regret. The number 2. In the dream state, your conscious defenses are lower than. It makes your thoughts vulnerable to theft. What Arthur is describing in this line is the concept of extraction. Inception doesn't just throw its titular concept at you for you to get your head around. It also throws equal mind blogging in universe concepts that the movie could have been named after, but wants to like extraction at you. The concept of extraction is then essentially what makes Inception a heist movie and not just a sci-fi movie. It is a sci-fi movie with a totally unique premise that is also a heist movie. Thanks to this line, in the dream state, your conscious defenses are lower, and it makes your thoughts vulnerable to theft. The number 1. Admit it. You don't believe in one reality anymore. All throughout Inception, we see Leonardo DiCaprio's character Dom Cobb grapple with the reality as he loses touch with the line between dream and real life. To be fair, as we watch the movie, headline stars could do blur for us too. That is a symptom of Nolan's genius. It doesn't help that he is constantly hunted by his deranged wife Molly. She messes with his head. No creeping doubts, no feeling persecuted Dom. Chased around the globe of anonymous corporations and police forces, the way the projection persecutes the dreamer. Admit it, you don't believe in her reality anymore. So choose to be here. Choose me. That's it. Thanks for the watching, viewers. Don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thanks for the watching and goodbye. Have a nice day.